ओके वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासरूम ऑफ चाकदह रामलाल एकेडमी। आई एम एवी सर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर 4 व्हिच हैज बीन स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 1500 बीसी टू 600 बीसी। द हेडिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट्स and we will discuss this. Welcome back to online classroom of Chakdhar Amral Academy. Due to coronavirus, for a long time we are out of classroom. But our school authority has decided to introduce this online education system. I hope everybody will be benefited and everybody will take active participation in this classroom. You everybody know, I am your AV sir and I am going to discuss our history subject and our this classroom teaching will be started from chapter 4, that is our second summative examination is ahead, and some unavoidable circumstances we have failed to arrange the first summative examination. You know what was the causes. Anyway, this online classroom teaching has been introduced by your school, that is Chakdah Ramlal Academy, for academic session 2020 of class 6 English medium. Now I will request all of you to follow the whiteboard. This is chapter 4, and in this chapter, ancient history of Indian subcontinent will be discussed here. In this chapter, the Indian history, we will discuss this chapter divided by two parts. One is Indo-European family, language family, and another is Vedic civilization. But you may ask, what is the relations between Indo-European language family and Vedic civilization? As a student of history subject, we shall come to know that there is a very, very close relation in between this topic, between this subject. Nothing is to be discussed without discussing the relation in between the chapter, the part of the chapter. There is a grassroots level relations in between this part of the chapter, Vedic civilization, the most important part. Already we heard the history of Ramayana, Mahabharata, Purana. What is this? This is the part of Vedic culture. After ending this part of our chapter, I will discuss shortly the Vedic civilization. Then you may find out the actual relation underlying in between this part. There is Vedic civilization and another is Indo-European language family. Anyway, for your information, I am telling you that in our textbook, that has been supplied by school education department. There are no sufficient information about Indo-European language family. But for our own interest, we shall have to know broadly this chapter, because it is the most important part for the ancient Indian history. Not only history, Indian race, Indian culture, Indian religion and everything. Now, I am going to demonstrate the Indo-European language family. Okay, everybody follow the board. This is Indo-European language family. This language group has been divided into 8 divisions. That is, you follow the board, you know Indo-European language, that is divided 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 part, and 8 languages has been introduced from this language group. First is Albanian. Albanian. Second one is Armenian. Then Balto-Slavic. Number 4, Celtic, Germanic, Greek, Indo-Iranian and Italic. This 8 language group has been introduced from this Indo-European language, or we may call it that actual originated from this group of language. The other part, this follow this board, the Indo-Iranian language, it has been 3 division. One is Indo-Aryan, Iranian, Nuristani. And the another part of this Indo-European language family, follow the board, Indo-Iranian, Iranian and Sanskrit. Iranian family group of language also divided some part, relevant part. Sindhi, Nepali, Hindustani, Kalushi, Bihari, Assamese, Bengali, Marathi, Gujarati, Punjabi and Sinhalese. For your information, I would like to say you, as we are the Bengali speaking students, we must know the matter of point that this is Sanskrit. Sanskrit is called the mother of Bengali language. Why? Because most of the Bengali word has been taken from Sanskrit. Not only that, and other foreign languages, and we have taken several words from other foreign languages, those languages or those words are called loan words. Just like example, Portuguese, Burmese, China, English language, Germanic, Italic, French, Arabian, and etc. Different type of language word has been taken for the above mentioned language groups. Theirs are called loan words. And Bengali is the only Bengali language is born from this Sanskrit language. Anyway, in this part, as it is under Vedic civilization, we shall know the one another important factor is Aryans. Till today, the problem of Aryans not has been solved. What is the problem? Problem is, who were the Aryans and from where they have come India? One of the group of Christians tried to prove that actually Aryans were Indian born. But there are no sufficient information and they have failed to prove that the Aryans were originated from India. But another group of Christians, just like R.C. Mozumdar, K.K. Dutta, Hem Chandra Rai to the ACRC, they have told in their books The Advanced History of India. Mr. A.L. Basham, one of his important historical work is The Wonder That Was in India. And they have proved that actually Aryans were not born in India. They have migrated into Indian subcontinent from where? That was Southeast Asian region, and that is called steppe, steppe. Steppe region was their inhabitant area. Then this is the most important things for our historical evidence. Now we shall have to discuss some word that was, so what is steppe, who were the Aryans, what is Aryabhatta, and why India is called Aryabhatta. We shall get I have used some terms, historical terms, that is steppe. What is steppe? I will ask you, what is steppe? And then another question is, who were the Aryans? Who were the Aryans? What is Aryabhatta? Why India is called Aryabhatta? When did Aryan come to India? The most important 5 questions in the chapter. I will discuss the questions gradually. What is steppe? What is steppe? The term steppe denotes the grassland, a low precipitation region which enough rain for grasses but not enough for trees. This is steppe region, which is belongs to Southeast Asian region. And the second question, who are the Aryans? Aryan has its roots as a term used as a self-designation by Indo-Iranian people. The term was used by the Indo-Aryan people of Vedic period in ancient India as a religious label for themselves and as well as the geographic region known as Aryabhatta, where Indo-Aryan culture is based. Again, who are the Aryans? I am repeating this answer. Arya has its roots as a term used as a self-designation by Indo-Iranian people. The term used was by the Indo-Aryan people of the Vedic period in ancient India as a religious label for themselves as well as the geographic region known as Aryabhatta, where Indo-Aryan culture is based. That is the Aryan. And here, what is Aryabhatta? What is Aryabhatta? Aryabhatta is yet another name which refers to India. This is probably the oldest one, but not much in common used these days. In ancient texts, There is sufficient uses of the word Aryabhat, that is Aryabhattu. The ancient name of current India means abode of Aryans. What is called Aryabhattu? Another question, what is, why India is called Aryabhattu? Why India is called Aryabhattu? To answer this question, I will tell you the information. Aryabhattu, the ancient name of country India. As you know, the Indian is called Aryabhat because Aryabhat means Arya, and the India is actual piece of Aryans, which is alternatively Brahmins. Aryabhat is a name for India in classical Sanskrit language. And my another question is, when did Aryan come to India? When did Aryan come to India? To answering this question, I will tell you, by 1500 BC, the Aryans migrated into Indian subcontinent, coming from Central Asia. This large group of nomadic cattle herds crossed the Hindu Kush mountain and come in contact with Indus Valley civilization. These are the answer of the questions, and I will send you the answer what I have told from a WhatsApp group, and everybody will prepare the answer. Anyway, this is the main subject matter which I have told you, and I will request all of you, everybody will ask me if you have any question, and I will try to answer your question my level best. Okay, thank you.